The Hawaiian Islands represent one of the largest concentrations of rare, threatened, or endangered plants anywhere on the globe.
If we think of all of the plants that really make up the base of the food chain that the human population is dependent upon, all of those contain fungal endophytes living inside their tissues. And a lot of studies have shown that these endophytes play roles in things like drought tolerance, resistance to various pathogens, so other fungi or bacteria. If we're going to conserve those plants and understand their biology and how to go about conserving them, we need to know about the fungi living inside of them.
And search this mutation, so misincorporation of base is a lot.
So in my lab, my student Sean has been to Hawaii with me on two occasions to collect samples and has really headed up the building of our living library of fungal cultures here in the lab and has been fantastic as far as mentoring the undergrads, training them on laboratory techniques. So student involvement is something that if it wasn't there, I probably wouldn't get any of this work done. We are building what's called a living library. So when we go out into the field, we're collecting the leaves of these native Hawaiian plants. We bring them back to the laboratory. We sort of capture them and we grow them in what we call pure culture. So if you open the fridge behind you, you'll see that it's filled with literally well over 1,000 different fungal cultures that are all, you know, essentially living in there in stasis and giving them to the USDA. So I've done some work in the past working with the College of Pharmacy at the University of Hawaii, where they were looking at fungi that we had isolated from native Hawaiian plants and screening those for anti-malarials and anti-cancer lead compounds. So the potential for this very, very large library that we're building is huge. They were the most amazing group of organisms to me. They were so alien in many aspects, and I think probably the most exciting thing was that they were so understudied. So there's lots and lots of efforts to grow these endangered plants in greenhouses in very sterile environments. And in many cases, those plants don't survive. If they do survive, they're not very healthy. If we can understand the microbes that are living in plants in the wild, then that gives us a much better way of approaching growing these rare and endangered plants and getting them ready to outplant into the wild.